Hey there, it's Bree, and this is not really an October TBR. So this video was originally supposed to be an October TBR, but then I went a little crazy because I already put together my Audible Escape to the End TBR, which is all the books that are on Audible Escape that I want to read before it goes away for the readathon. And I know that that's going to be the majority of what I read this month. I decided that I wanted to do a whole separate October TBR that was separate from the Audible Escape TBR. I have a lot of books on my shelf and on my Kindle that are very like Halloween-y that I want to read this month, but there is no way in Satan's overflowing laundry basket that I am going to get to all of these books. So maybe this is more of like a books from my bookshelf that are Halloween-y or books that I want to read that are Halloween-y. Maybe I need to find a different word than Halloween-y. Like, I didn't want to call it fall because these aren't really fall books. They're just books that either have like creepy covers or have monsters in it or they're paranormal. So some of these would be good recommendations for the paranormal readathon that's happening. I will link information about that down below. So maybe this is kind of a hybrid. Maybe it's a rec video. It's not really a rec video because I haven't read these yet. It's just a TBR of all my paranormal Halloween-y books that I want to read. That was a really convoluted introduction. I am very sorry. Hopefully I get my act together by the time I'm editing this video. Let's actually start with a book that I'm definitely reading this month because it's a graphic novel and it's going to be a super quick read. It's a book that I meant to read last year for Halloween, but I didn't. It is Pumpkinhead. It's by Rainbow Rowell and Faith Erin Hicks. And this one looks so stinking cute. I love the artwork in this. And for some reason, I just did not get to this in time last year, but I definitely will this year because the majority of my books that I'm going to read this month and into next month are going to be on audio. So I do want a couple of things to read physically. This is about Josie and Deja, I think. And they are seniors. They have worked all through high school at this pumpkin patch every year. And I'm guessing they've always been attracted to each other maybe, but I think it's a romance between the two of them, and it's supposed to be super cute. I love Rainbow Rowell's romances, so I can't wait to read this one. Next is a book that I fully bought as a cover buy because I thought that the cover looked amazing and it's so Halloween-y. I added it to this list. It is The Lantern's Ember. This cover is gorgeous. The fireflies in this, or whatever kind of bugs those are, they look like they're glowing, but it's just so Halloween-y, right? Like, how could I not add this to my list? So I don't even fully know what this book is about, but the author is the author of the Tiger's Curse series. Let's see what it's about because I don't actually know. Ooh, the main character's name is Ember. Oh, she's a witch. So this is a witchy. This is a YA fantasy and or paranormal. The main character is a witch, so that's awesome. She's always felt this draw to this bridge in her town, and apparently it turns out that it's a gateway to the other world. It says it's a realm crawling with fiendish beasts. So this just sounds like it's perfect for Halloween. It says, Jack is an ever-vigilant watchman, and he's committed to keeping mortals away. That, like, his job is to keep mortals away from this other world, but then, of course, Ember comes along, and she's drawn to it, and then he ends up falling for her. So he's supposed to be keeping her away from it, but he ends up falling for her instead. That sounds good. This next book is another book that I meant to read last year in October, but I didn't. It is called House of Salt and Sorrows, and this one is by Aaron A. Craig. How gorgeous is this cover? This cover is stunning. So is like the back cover too. And it is blurbed by Stephanie Garber. If you do not know, Stephanie Garber wrote Caraval, and Caraval is my all-time favorite YA fantasy series. She says, step inside a fairy tale. So I believe this is a retelling of, it's a retelling of the 12 Dancing Princesses. So it has a bunch of ghosts and gods, and it takes place on the water, but I heard that it's supposed to be a little bit like chilling and very atmospheric, so very, very excited to read this one. This next one is a book that I picked out solely because of the cover. It has a skull on the cover and it looks awesome. It's called The Bone Houses. This one is by Emily Lloyd Jones. This one, I think, is about zombies. It says on the back here, no warrior could stop the risen dead, but perhaps a grave digger could. Like, how perfect is that for Halloween? Seriously. Like, I didn't realize. It's funny because I knew that I wanted to read Halloween-y books for October, but I was like, I don't think I have any books on my shelf. But then I remembered that I have a ton of YA fantasy and YA paranormal romance on my bookshelf, and that means a lot of these type of books. So exciting. This will give me a good reason to read some of these. So this next one is by an indie author. I got this book at the last Shameless Book Con that I went to, and I was immediately drawn to the cover. And then when I found out what this book was about and what all the books in the series were about, I was like, oh my gosh, give it to me. As soon as you see the cover, you'll see what I mean. It's perfect for Halloween. This one is called Crane. It's by Stacey Rourke. It's The Legend Saga, book number one. And I believe every single book in the saga is a retelling of a fairy tale. And this one is a Rip Van Winkle retelling. So it just sounds really good. So it says, Washington Irving and Rip Van Winkle had no choice but to cover up the deadly truth behind Ichabod Crane's disappearance. Centuries later, a crane returns to Sleepy Hollow, awakening macabre secrets once believed to be buried deep. What if the monster that spawned the legend lived within you? It just sounds creepy and dark and awesome and perfect for Halloween. And I'm just obsessed with this cover. Obsessed with it. So this next book, although having a very creepy cover, has a lot of fond memories attached to it because I bought it when I was on vacation at the beach at this tiny little beachside bookshop, and I found it there and I was like, this looks amazing. It is called Troll's Eye View. It's a book of villainous tales. So again, perfect for Halloween. I think this is going to be one that I'm going to read because it's super short, but it has a bunch of awesome authors in it that have contributed short stories to this collection. So Holly Black is in here, Neil Gaiman, a bunch of other authors. The only two that I recognize are Holly Black and Neil Gaiman. And as soon as I saw Holly Black and Neil Gaiman's names on here, I was like, I'm getting it. And also, I just love villainous tales. Like, I'm super into that. I'm such a big fan of books told from the villain's point of view. And this is what this whole collection is. So it has like The Giant's Wife from Jack and the Beanstalk, The Oldest of the 12 Dancing Princesses, Rumpelstiltskin, The Witch from Hansel and Gretel, Someone Called Evil Cinderella. Stop, this sounds amazing. This is like top of my list to read. And then on this list is Dread Nation. This is by Justina Ireland. This is one of those books that I bought purely on the cover because the cover is just stunning and it just drew my eye. And I found it for like 25 cents at my local bookshop. But it turns out that this is a zombie novel, and I had no freaking idea that it was until like a while after I bought it. But apparently it takes place in the battlefields of Gettysburg, Pennsylvania, and there are zombies that have risen. It's like a zombie war, I think, that's happening in this, but it just sounds really good and perfect for Halloween. This has deckled edges. I don't know. I know a lot of people hate these. I think they're beautiful and they look really good. So I know people hate them, but I love them. So this is another anthology that I bought because it has a couple of authors that I really like, or that authors that I have not read yet that I want to try. And this sounds like it is perfect for Halloween. It is Slasher Girls and Monster Boys. It says it's classic tales, brand new nightmares. Some of the authors are Jay Kristoff, there's Lee Bardugo, Mary Lou. So there's some great authors on here, really popular authors. And of course, it sounds like these are kind of like horrifying fairy tale retellings. And this is another one that I'm really hoping to get to. A powerhouse anthology featuring some of the best thriller and horror writers around. And I know that my library actually has this on audio, so I may borrow it and listen to it on audio, but it just sounds really, really good and perfect for Halloween. And then another book that I'm hoping to get to, don't know if I will, is the Dark Fairy Tales anthology. I downloaded this on Kindle. There are some awesome romance writers who are part of this anthology, and I feel like a dark romance anthology would be great for Halloween. Let me look it up because I don't remember all the authors that are on it. Again, I love fairy tale retellings. These are dark fairy tale retellings, and I'm so here for it. Okay. Yeah, it's 537 pages, so it's kind of long. I'm not sure if I will get to it, but authors include Willow Winters, Alethea Romig, who is Steph from Steph's Romance Book Talk. It's her favorite author. Karina Halley is in it. TM Frazier, Sky Warren, Cora Riley, Sierra Simone, come on. So some of the titles are The Ugly Duckling, Beauty and the Beast, Cinderella, Little Red Riding Hood, Jack and the Beanstalk, Snow White, Rumpelstiltskin, King Midas, King Thrushbeard, Princess and the Pea, that one's by Sierra Simone, and Swan Princess. Like, tell me that doesn't sound freaking amazing. Maybe I do need to read this. Gosh darn it. Why are there so many books I want to read this month? And we're already like partway through the month. What am I doing with my life? Another one that I want to read from my bookshelf is The Shadows Between Us. This is by Trisha Levenseller. I've heard great things about the romance in this one. I believe it is one of those situations where the heroine goes to maybe kill the hero. He's like a king of shadows or something, but then ends up falling for him. And it's kind of hate to lovey and kind of dark. And I don't know, it just sounds really, really good. Like, it sounds right up my alley. And this cover is freaking gorgeous. I love the purple on it. I think this was a special edition, one of the book boxes that I used to get. But yeah, this one just sounds really good. And it sounds like it would be perfect for Halloween. And then another book that would be perfect for Halloween is a vampire novel called Crave by Tracy Wolf. I believe the second book maybe just came out, so that would be really good timing. This is a beast of a book though. I think this is going to be one that I'm going to have to read on audio. It's a vampire novel. This cover is giving me major Twilight vibes. Like, I'm sorry, but anything that is all black and then has white with a little bit of red on it will always give me Twilight vibes. So I don't know. I've heard mixed things about this one. I've heard that it's slow from some people. I've heard from other people that it's really, really good. So I'm very interested to see what I think of it. So that one is on my list because vampires, Halloween, hello. And then last but not least is a book called Awakened. And this is a book that Bree Hill read a while ago and she raved about it. She said she really, really liked it. It's about witches. And I feel like we just all need more books about witches in our lives. I'm pretty sure it's an adult novel too. It's supposed to be really good. I think a few people read this one for the Kindle Clearout Readathon and enjoyed it. So I added it to my list because witches, hello, Halloween, works out really well. All right, guys, that's it. I hope you found some great books to read this month. I am overwhelmed with the amount of books that I want to read this month between Audible Escape going away and then Halloween and all the Halloween-y books and then the Paranormal Romance Readathon. I just want to read all the books and yet I don't have enough time, but that's okay. I will prioritize the ones that I was talking about that I want to read the most. So let me know down below if you've read any of these books, which ones are your favorite, which ones you think I should prioritize. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, happy reading!